Namaskar and good evening, everybody. It's a great pleasure and honor to be standing before all of you to welcome Professor Lawrence Summers. As all of us know, he is an eminent personality in the fields that we can just think of, and he has contributed a lot in each of those fields. We have amongst us on the dais Shri Sudhindra Kulkarni, the founder of ORF, and also we have senior professors, principals of affiliated colleges of the university, eminent academicians and scholars, students of the university as well as affiliated institutions, and thinkers and citizens of this great city of Mumbai. As all of us know, the university has already entered in the 159th year of its existence, and since the time that I have been shouldering this responsibility as the Vice Chancellor of this great institution, it is 151 days since I have been on my toes. I have been very fortunate that I have been able to take forward the legacy of this great institution as well as the founders and leaders who gave a shape to its structure and function, what it is today. We have had an enormous amount of contribution by the scholars who got educated and achieved wisdom by their association with University of Mumbai, and we can proudly say that his institution, even though amongst 800 universities in the country, is ranked in the top class institutions of the world for various reasons. And one of the reasons that we can be proud for is that the way we are able to reach the unreached sections of society by way of methods which we have been able to modify, adapt, as well as adjust as per the requirements of fast changing scenario of the global education systems. We have been able to align ourselves with the nation's agenda of Skill India Mission, Digital India Mission, and what we call it as Incredible India Mission. In the recent past, the people who have provided leadership to the university have been able to take it in the forefront of countries' priorities. And I'm very fortunate that in the last couple of years, the way India has been able to reach out to the global fraternity and prove a point that even though traditionally we were the first in terms of attaining what we call it as equitable sharing of resources in terms of knowledge, we are still one of the leaders in the world where we believe that blending of traditional technologies and modern technologies can pave way to the entire world, a path on which not only India is walking, but it can take along with it all those who believe in ecological security, economic efficiency, and social equity. At a global level, we are experiencing a paradigm shift in education. And as all of us are very fortunate to have Professor Lawrence Summers, who has been at the helm of the affairs of not only education, because he has been the president of Harvard University, but he has been in the forefront of most of the activities that have led the country which he belongs to, the United States of America, at a level where it now contributes to the greatest amount of GDP as comparison with any other country in the world. I would like to briefly introduce Professor Lawrence Summers for the benefit of those who may not have had the opportunity to read what he has written, to listen what he conceived, and to see what he actually delivered in terms of execution of his ideas. Lawrence Henry, or Larry Summers, is an American economist who has been the president and now president emeritus, and Charles W. Eliot University professor of Harvard University. At the age of 16, he entered the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, where he originally intended to study physics, but soon switched to economics. He was also an active member of the MIT debating team and qualified for participation in the annual national debate. Tournament of this kind, it is very rare for a person to enter even once, but he participated in this tournament 3 times. He attended the Harvard University as a graduate student. He completed his doctoral work in 1982, and at the age of 28 in 1983, he became one of the youngest tenured professors in Harvard's history. As a researcher, Professor Summers has made important contributions in many areas of economics, primarily public finance, labor economics, financial economics, and macroeconomics. He has also worked in international economics, economic demography, economic history, and development economics. He completed his tenure and switched over from Harvard in 1991, and working as a chief economist at the World Bank from 1991 to 93. In 1993, Professor Summers was appointed Undersecretary for International Affairs of the United States Department of the Treasury under the Clinton administration. In 1995, he was promoted to Deputy Secretary of the Treasury and then as a Secretary of Treasury in 1999. While working for Clinton administration, Summers played a leading role in the American response to 1994 economic crisis in Mexico, the 1997 Asian financial crisis, and the Russian financial crisis. He was also influential in the American advised privatization of the economies of post-Soviet states, and the delegation which he led also contributed in the deregulation of the US financial systems, including the repeal of Glass-Steagall Act. Following the end of Clinton's term, Professor Summers served as the 27th president of the Harvard University from the year 2001 to 2006. He rejoined the public service during the Obama administration, serving as the director of the White House United States National Economic Council for President Barack Obama from January 2000 until November 2010. When he emerged as a key economic decision maker in the Obama administrator's response to the Great Recession. After his departure from the National Economic Council in December 2010, Professor Summers has worked in the private sector and also as a columnist in major newspapers. It is said that Larry Summers, and I quote, has the rare ability to see the world that is taking shape and the skill to help bring it to being, unquote. Professor Summers has been recognized as one of the world's most influential thinkers by the Time, Foreign Policy, Prospect, and The Economist magazines, among many others. Investing in all the people, understanding underemployment are two of his formal publications which have been published in the form of a book. There are quite a few similarities between America and India. We have been talking about a nation which has got a leadership in every aspect and in true sense of the term, by way of providing guidelines to the entire world and taking it to a level where everybody aspires to reach. In India, we are talking about a nation which is one of the youngest in the 21st century. 55% of our population is below the age group of 25. However, 93% of our undergraduates fail to get admitted at the postgraduate level. And that is where the contribution of the United States in uplifting the livelihoods of underprivileged sections which are economically underprivileged can come in handy when India is marching ahead with its national agenda, which is a global priority today in terms of skill development and also digitization of academic institutions. It is very important that we work together and carry forward the message that the University of Mumbai and one of the greatest institutions of American history, the Harvard University, can bring together a partnership which will foster alignment between the great thinkers, philosophers, and most importantly, political leaders, because I personally believe, and everybody would agree, that no one can achieve anything unless there is a political will. And therefore, to end my very long introduction, I would like to thank once again one of our true thinkers, Shri Sudhindra Kulkarni and his team, to have given us an opportunity to jointly organize this very important function and bring to you Professor Larry Summers. I once again welcome you, sir, for this important occasion and this historic convocation hall of the 158-year-old University of Mumbai, Professor Larry Summers.